is going on, guys? Your shredded brother from another mother, and I have some bad news. You were tricked. You clicked on a video that promised you 10 foods that are gonna help you melt stubborn belly fat, and the reality is you absolutely cannot spot reduce where you lose body fat. But if, say, you lose 15 pounds of fat over the course of a shred, so I'm shredding really hard right now, if you guys have been following the shred series, and I've probably lost about 12 to 13 pounds of body fat overall. So of course, some of these 12 to 13 pounds of fat are gonna be in your belly area. Now, what makes a fat loss food is its ability to keep you really full without a lot of calories. So take a look at these three foods I have right here on this plate. We have a couple cups of popcorn, we have a healthy protein bar, and we have about 2 tablespoons of peanut butter. Now, one of these fat loss foods is amazing. In fact, it's the first one on our list. The other two aren't. Can you guys guess right now which one is which? So I have been eating popcorn every single day, and the reason is very simple. This has 5 grams of fiber, and this entire plate right here only has 100 calories. So I can eat like a giant amount of popcorn out to here, and it's only about 400 calories, and it's gonna make me really full. This protein bar right here, it's actually a very healthy protein bar brand. It's 280 calories for this little protein bar right here. Look at that. Barely fills up the popcorn plate. And then peanut butter, a lot of people think it's a great fat loss food, it's great on a diet. I disagree, because this little thing of peanut butter right here is almost 200 calories. That means this right here, this is almost 2 tablespoons of peanut butter. This is almost twice as many calories as all this popcorn right here. So popcorn is the first fat loss food on the list, and I recommend that you get a low fat type of popcorn. So I really like this brand called Buddha Bowl, and I get the popcorn that literally just has a little bit of coconut oil and pink sea salt. Now, very important, before I get into the other 9 best fat loss foods that I've been eating almost daily, make sure you guys stick around until the very end, because Alpha Lion just turned 2 years old. There's this damn bee flying by me. Anyways, Alpha Lion just turned 2 years old. So we're doing an epic giveaway for Alpha Lion's 2nd birthday, and I'm gonna share with you my exact full day of eating and my exact shredding calories. I'm about 200 pounds right now, so I think it'd be really helpful for you guys if I literally just show you my full day of eating and the quantity of everything that I'm eating and my fat loss calories. So make sure you guys stick around until the very end, and also give this video a big like and tap that notification bell next to the subscribe button, that you're gonna miss out on all the amazing future videos, and you'll be cursed with small calves for the rest of your life. Next up on the list is egg whites. Now, egg whites are about the only food that I can think of in the entire world where it is 100% pure protein. So I buy a big carton of liquid egg whites. It has 0 grams of fat, it has 0 grams of carbohydrates, and 100 grams of protein in the entire carton. So pretty much all of my breakfast while I'm shredding is I will do 1 cup of liquid egg whites, which is gonna give me 25 grams of protein, and then I'll mix in 1 whole egg. So the macros of that is gonna be 31 grams of protein and only 4 grams of fat. This is gonna save me a ton of calories, as opposed to eating, say, like 4 to 5 whole eggs for breakfast. Number 3 and 4 on the list are foods that I always eat together for breakfast as well, and that is oats and blueberries. And the reason is very simple. Once again, volume. You've got to make yourself full to be in a caloric deficit. The only thing that really matters to burn belly fat, you could literally eat Snickers candy bars and ice cream, and if you're, say, at 2000 calories and it's like completely full of ice cream and Snickers candy bars, and your maintenance calories are 2700, you're gonna be in a 700 calorie deficit for the day. The problem with that approach to your diet is those foods are gonna spike your insulin, you're gonna crash, and then you're gonna get really hungry again. So you've gotta make yourself full, and oatmeal and blueberries is, in my opinion, the most perfect breakfast, because blueberries are a very low calorie fruit, much lower calorie than, say, bananas, and they're very delicious, they're packed with antioxidants, they pair perfectly with oatmeal, and then One half cup of dry oats. It's only about 150 calories. It's loaded with fiber as well. So it's got a lot of slow digesting carbohydrates, a lot of fiber, and it's always my pre-workout meal on my shred. So I'll have the liquid egg whites, I'll have the blueberries with the oats, and that's basically my shredding breakfast. And then I'll train about 90 minutes later after that breakfast. Number cinco on the list, since I'm in beautiful Medellin, Colombia, I'll break out the Spanish in today's video, is I wanted to say like spinach, but you could literally put any greens on this list, because one of my go-to dinners on my shred is I will take a giant bowl of greens and I'll just basically make a high protein green salad. So 1 pound of spinach is the perfect shredding food because it's got like 12 grams of protein. It's only got about 50 total calories. It's loaded with antioxidants, loaded with vitamins and minerals. So you could eat a giant bowl of greens, loaded up with like 50 grams of chicken breast or steak, put the dressing of your choice, and it's only gonna be like a 300 to 400 calorie dinner. It's gonna make you really full. So if you compare, say, you're gonna be more full eating that giant green salad that's only like 400 calories than you would if you had, say, like 1200 calories of pasta. So my greens salads are my go-to. When I'm like deep in my shred and I'm trying to eat only like 1800, 1900 calories a day, I'll actually eat two green salads for the day. I'll have one for dinner and then I'll have this bee. Number six on the list is casein protein. Now, this is actually much different than whey protein isolate and whey protein concentrate because the rate of digestion. So it's all about keeping ourselves full. And the reason that I really like casein protein is if I take it later in the day, or even if I take it 1 to 2 hours before bed, it's gonna really have a slow drip of amino acids. And this is really critical when you're in a caloric deficit and you're shredding, because the goal of a shred is not only to maximize how much fat you lose, it is to maintain your muscle mass, maintain your energy levels and your strength and workout intensity in the gym. So I like having casein protein later in the day, typically about 2 hours before bedtime if I have some calories left on my macros. So it's giving me like a slow drip. I don't know the exact rate of digestion, but I think it's about 4 to 5 hours, where something like a whey protein isolate is perfect for post-workout because it digests super fast. So I do about 30 to 35 grams of casein protein. I actually been going with a brand that's half casein and half concentrate. I just don't really like the taste of pure casein, so that combination of splitting it up half and half gives it a much better taste. So I recommend either or. We're actually working to develop an epic slow release protein for Alpha Lion that's not out yet, so make sure you guys stay tuned on that. So numbers 7, 8, and 9 on the list I'm gonna put together because they are my three favorite choices for lean protein. Lean protein is going to keep you more full. It's more thermogenic. It takes your body more calories to digest it. So obviously sticking with really low calorie sources of lean protein is critical on your shred. So boneless, skinless chicken breast, 99% fat-free ground turkey, and basically any white fish are gonna be the top three choices. I would actually say pretty much like any fish other than salmon. Now, you see salmon on a lot of fat loss lists. Salmon's a great food. You can of course eat salmon. You can literally eat any food in the world and still lose body fat. The reason that I stay away from a lot of salmon on my shred, unless I'm really accurately tracking my macros, is this reason. Let's say for instance you have a pound of salmon and a couple tablespoons of peanut butter in your diet. That right there is adding about like 40 grams of fat to your diet. So on my shred diet, I'm only eating 60 to 70 grams of fat all day. So I basically can't have any foods that have fat the rest of the day if I had a lot of salmon and say a lot of peanut butter. So the calories of salmon really add up. And to me, it just doesn't taste that much better than any other form of fish where I'd want to sacrifice all those extra calories. So I would stick with white fish, I would stick with lean ground turkey, and I would stick with boneless, skinless chicken breast. Numero 10, the last one on the list. I just want to list out basically the only things that I drink when I'm shredding. Copy this list, write it down, put it on your refrigerator, whatever you got to do, because liquid calories are the worst thing in the world when you're shredding because they will not make you full at all. So the only things that I drink when I'm shredding is a ton of water, usually with a lot of lemon in it. I'll sometimes put 1 to 2 tablespoons of apple cider vinegar in water and I'll chug it after meals to make myself full. Green tea and coffee are amazing. No calories there. Make sure you don't add a lot of creamer and sugar. No white girl frappuccinos and things like that. What else? We have coconut water. Intra-workout and post-workout coconut water, especially on leg day, are great because when you're shredding, you're depleting your body of a lot of crucial electrolytes. So coconut water is going to be amazing. It's very low in calories. Get the kind with no sugar added. It's only 40 calories per 8 ounces. And then of course the Alphaline supplements that I recommend when you're shredding. Pre-workout is great, maximizing your workout intensity when you're in a caloric deficit. Superhuman is my go-to. Cheetah is our new fat burner. And stick around until the very end because we're actually doing a giveaway for Cheetah. This is a max dose fat burner that has a lot of fat burning properties because not only is it going to put you in a more thermogenic state, it's going to keep you full, it's going to help you burn excess calories, and it tastes amazing, and it also has no calories. And then on days when I'm not drinking a lot of coconut water, I'll replace the coconut water with unicorn. So that's all 9 essential amino acids, and it's got some electrolytes in it as well. So it's got actually 2 grams of coconut water powder with all 9 essential amino acids. So pretty much like no calories, and it's giving my body all the amino acids and electrolytes I need. I pretty much drink nothing else other than those items on that list, because if I have 300 calories of say soda or sweet tea or lemonade, it's gonna be really hard to only eat 2300 to 2400 calories for the day, because that's just filling me up with liquid calories. It's spiking my insulin, and then I'm plummeting back down, and I'm gonna get really hungry again. So as promised, here is my full day of eating on my shred diet with exact quantities and calories. I did this for about a week straight before coming to Colombia, and I lost about 2 pounds of body fat in a week doing this exact diet. Meal number 1, 1/2 cup oats with 1 cup blueberry, a little bit of cinnamon, a little bit of stevia to sweeten, 1 cup egg whites mixed with 1 whole egg, a little bit of black pepper, garlic, hot sauce, and pink salt, give me a grand total of 37 grams of protein, 50 grams of carbs, 10 grams of fat. I'll work out 90 minutes after this meal. I'll take either Cheetah Fat Burner or Superhuman pre-workout about 60 minutes after this meal. Intra-workout, I will do about 10 ounces of coconut water, giving me 20 grams of carbohydrates. Snack number 1 is my post-workout protein. I will do 40 grams of fast-digesting whey protein isolate, drinking the not-yet-to-be-released Alphaline protein powder. Stay tuned for that update. So that's 40 grams of protein right there. Meal number 2 is my post-workout meal, about 1 hour after I train. 30 minutes to 1 hour after I train, I'll do 6 ounces of 99% fat-free ground turkey, 8 ounces of red skin boiled potatoes. I'll mix in salt, pepper, garlic, about 1/2 tablespoon of grass-fed butter, giving me 40 grams of protein, 50 grams of carbs, 10 grams of fat. Then about an hour later, I will reward myself with a nice all-natural protein bar, white chocolate cranberry, I think it's called the Outright Bar. 15 grams of protein, 30 grams of carbs, and 12 grams of fat. Snack number 2 is I will do 2 cups of Buddha Bowl popcorn, and I'll do 1 cup liquid egg whites with a little bit of sliced avocado, giving me 20 grams of fat, 35 grams of carbs, and 32 grams of protein. And then my last meal of the day is I'll do that large green salad. I'll have 40 grams of chicken breast, about 1 pound of greens. I'll pick a dressing that I enjoy, like a Thai peanut or an Asian soy, giving me 50 grams of protein, 50 grams of carbs, and 15 grams of fat, giving me a grand total for the day of 214 grams of protein, 235 grams of carbs, and 67 grams of fat for 2,399 calories. If I eat that every single day, I will get super shredded. My maintenance calories are almost 3,000. That gives me about a 600 calorie deficit for the day, giving me more than a 1 pound of fat loss per week through my diet alone. So now we're up to the Gains Squad giveaway. And before we get into that, give this video a big like, and you have got to tap that notification bell next to the subscribe button to enter the Gains Squad giveaway. So we're giving 1 bottle of Cheetah Fast Acting Fat Burner and Rambo Raz. And all you have to do to enter is comment down below. Since the NBA Finals just ended, I was heartbroken because my favorite player, Kevin Durant, tore his Achilles tendon. Toronto just won last night. We're out at a bar in Medellin watching the game. Pretty epic game, very entertaining. So all you have to do to enter is comment down below your favorite basketball player of all time. If you don't have a favorite player, comment down below your favorite NBA team. So all you have to do is comment that down below, tap that notification bell next to subscribe. So really looking forward to hearing from the other NBA fans on the channel. So thank you guys so much for watching. I'm gonna link right here to my video on how to calculate your fat loss macros, because all these foods mean nothing unless you know your exact fat loss macros. I'm gonna link over here to the shredding videos from the 2019 shred playlist. This is the 7th shred video in the playlist. So lots of gold nuggets in the other videos. So I'm gonna link to that over here, and I will see you guys on the next video.